my name is Ken Robinson, and I'm a writer, an educator, a speaker. I've been involved in education for a very long time, as you can see, and my big interest has long been to cultivate and promote the extraordinary creative talents that every young person has and brings into the world. So I'm genuinely thrilled to be asked to say a few words to this amazing gathering in Rome of ICANN, the first ICANN Global Summit here in Rome. My welcome to you, to the parents, to the superheroes that you all are, to the teachers, and also to the wonderful partners who brought this event together, including, of course, Design for Change, which is the big driving force in all this great work. You know, I've been involved, as you are, in promoting the global goals for sustainable development. And this is a to-do list for the future of our planet. It could hardly be more important. And like any to-do list, it needs people to do it. And this isn't just a job for young people. I know people always say, you're the future. Well, you are. Of course you are. But also, it's the responsibility of everybody on the planet to gather around this extraordinary agenda for change and to do everything they can to bring it about. You see, we can bring it about, and I'll tell you why I think that is. Human talents, I believe, are like the world's natural resources. You know, you can travel all round the cosmos. I don't suppose you will do, but if you were to do that in your imagination. You know, there's a lot of talk and speculation about whether there is life beyond this planet. Well, we don't know, is the truth. We haven't really found anything just yet. What we do know is that this life, this planet, is teeming with life. Life here is everywhere. It's on the ground, it's in the air, it's under the oceans, it's everywhere to be seen in multiple forms. But among all this extraordinary life in this very delicate ecosystem that we all occupy and depend upon, human beings do occupy a special place. You know, there are all kinds of ways in which we are just like the rest of life on Earth. We are mortal, we depend on what the planet provides, we depend on its water, we depend on the food that we can help it to produce, we depend on its natural resources in every way. But there is some way in which we are different from the rest of life on Earth, and that gives us an even greater responsibility. We are gifted with extraordinary powers of imagination and creativity. If you look around you in this beautiful city that you're now sitting in, this building that you're having this meeting in, this isn't something that was discovered before we got here. These buildings were created, these artifacts were created by the power of human imagination and ingenuity. Human beings don't just live in the world as we find it, we change it. We create the world that we live in through the technologies that we evolve, through the languages that we speak, the ideas that we have, you know, everything to the clothes that we wear, the buildings that we occupy, the food that we eat. We transform the planet through the power of imagination. That's the superpower that we all of us have in mind. But here's the thing, that this superpower that we uniquely have as human beings has also brought us to a rather critical pass. The challenges that we face now on Earth are very largely of our own making. There was a very interesting film on the BBC a little while back. It was called How Many People Can Live on Earth? It's a rather literal approach to it, I felt. But the issue is that there are now more people on the planet than at any time in the history of humanity. We are now about over 7.5 billion people on the Earth. That's about almost 10% of all the people who've ever lived. So far as anybody knows, since the dawn of human history, there have been about 120 billion people on the planet. And we're heading towards sort of 10% of that. So we're putting a big strain on the planet in the way that we live. By our appetites, by the way that we use the resource of the planet. Other creatures aren't creating these challenges, frankly. We are. And what that means is that we're also capable of tackling them, but we have to think differently in order to do that. We have to dig deep into our natural powers and resources. So when I say human resources are like the world's natural resources, this is true in a few ways. One of them is they're tremendously diverse. Just like the resource in the Earth are very wide-ranging and multifarious, it's true of people as well. All of you here, from the 40 countries from which you come, all the faiths and cultures that you live in, all of you are unique individuals nonetheless. There has never been a person like you in the whole history of humanity. None of the other 120 billion people have been just like you, and they're not going to live the life that you're about to live and that you're living right now. We all have very deep natural talents. We don't always discover them, but they're there nonetheless. And the second way in which our resource are like those natural resources is that even when we discover these talents, we have to develop them, we have to refine them, we have to hone them. You know, my guess is that there are some of you here today who speak 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe, I don't know, 6 languages. I don't, honestly. I speak the one I'm speaking now and a little bit of French and even less German. But a lot of people speak many languages, and the reason is that they grew up where these languages were spoken, or they lived in places where these languages were spoken. We all of us could speak many languages. The fact is that we often only speak one because that's what we're exposed to. The difference is about opportunity and about practicing a capacity. We have the capacity to speak many languages, but we don't all have the ability to do it. It's the same with music. It's the same with science. It's the same with mathematics. It's the same with craft work. It's the same with any form of human activity. If we practice, if we put our minds to it, we could achieve all kinds of things that currently we may not think we're capable of, but we could be if we were to apply ourselves to them. And the third way in which human resources are like the world's natural resources is that we have to realize the value of these talents and abilities, put them to work. So you all have deep resources, deep talents, and we're faced, all of us collectively, not just young people, but all of us on the earth just now, with great challenges. And the wonderful thing about this gathering, about the ICANN Global Summit, is you're all joined here today, you've all come here to Rome, to talk about not only what you can do individually, which is enormous, by the way, but what you can do collectively, which is even greater. You know, change often happens through small steps. Small steps can lead to very big change. So never feel that if you do something that seems small to you, that it may not have a very big impact. It may well, and particularly if it gets multiplied to the partnerships, the efforts, and the commitment of the movement that you're now part of. So congratulations on all you're doing. Welcome to Rome. Thank you to all the people who've been hosting you, to the partners who brought you together. We do have big challenges, but we have lots of talents to meet them, and I wish you every success and my very best wishes in all you've done and all that you're about to do for yourself and for all of us. Thank you.